So we just recently turned on our solar system on our house, and it has been really a cool experience, and we've learned a lot. But it's also given me a lot of time to think about who solar is good for and who it's not, because solar can be a great resource, but it's not a good fit for everyone. So in this video, we'd like to talk about some of those things that you need to consider in deciding whether or not you want to install with solar, something else, or just nothing at all. So when people are considering solar, they're doing it for two reasons. One of two reasons, or both. The first reason is usually economic. They want to save money on their electric bill. And the second reason is environmental. They want to decrease their carbon footprint and find a more renewable way to support the community, support society, and make a smaller carbon footprint on the world and leave a better place for our children. And that's fantastic. However, both of these goals aren't always met by using solar, and we'd like to talk about those. So for either one of these, if you live in a place that is not generally sunny, you are not going to get a financial or an environmental payback with your solar panels. If you're in Seattle and it's overcast 150, 200, I don't know how many days, the majority of the time, then you're just not going to be making any money, and you're not going to be making any electricity, and you're not going to be benefiting yourself at all. If you live in Phoenix, you know, that makes it a lot better for you. So that's something you should definitely consider. And you should look at the statistics. Don't just think, well, it seems rather cloudy here a lot. They have all sorts of information out there. So do that sort of research to make sure that you're in a good spot in terms of sun to get enough power to actually make it worth it for you. Also, you need to make sure you actually own your home. If you rent your home, it doesn't make any sense. Why would you put your solar panels on somebody else's house? You would need to get their permission, and then if you decided to move, you're not going to have that equity. So it just doesn't make any sense if you're going to do that for a financial reason, and perhaps not for an environmental reason, but that depends on your situation. Of equal importance is the ability to actually put them somewhere. A lot of people live in rather small, cramped areas and may have a very strange roofline where there's just legitimately not a spot to put them. If you don't have a good unshaded spot to put them, then you're not a good fit. If you don't have a backyard where you can put them, or you don't want to use your backyard for solar panels, which I totally understand, then you would not be a good fit for them. So just these logistical things that you need to keep in mind of if they're not going to actually produce you any energy, it's not going to meet either of those economic or environmental goals. Now, that being said, if you live somewhere where you want to be off-grid and you're way out in the middle of nowhere, then solar is a good option for you. If you can find a creek and put a hydropower dam in there, like just a small little thing, that's wonderful, but not everybody has access to that in the middle of nowhere. So if you're living off grid, solar is actually a pretty good option for you, even if you do live in Canada or live in some place where it's pretty cloudy. So that's one of those things where it's gonna depend on whether or not the economic or environmental impact is helpful based on where you are. So in addition to those climate concerns and the amount of space that you have and that shaping the decision, it also depends on where you live in the world. So we live in Idaho here, and the cost for electricity is extremely low. So from an economic perspective, it's a little bit harder to justify solar. We were able to do it because we did all of the installation ourselves and drove the cost down significantly. But if we were to use a solar installer, it would make absolutely no economic sense for us. Now, if you were to live in California, where their very bottom tier rate is higher than Idaho's highest tier rate, or basically the same, it makes a lot more economic sense to do it down there, plus the fact that it tends to be a little bit more sunny down there. So it really does depend on where you are in terms of whether or not you're going to get that money back. And from an environmental perspective, it's the same. Again, in Idaho, the reason our electric bills are so low is because we have a cheap, inexpensive, and environmentally friendly source of power in hydroelectric dams. So for us in Idaho, environmental reasons are a little bit harder to justify. However, if you live somewhere else where coal is still your predominant power source, then that does make more sense from an environmental perspective to actually get the panels and to be more self-sustainable. Now, the interesting thing is that for either economic or environmental reasons, if you want to do solar, have you considered putting that money towards something else? So when we built this house, we put the insulation in on the walls, but we didn't put the insulation in the attic. And during the summer, when we were walking up the stairs during the construction process, you could feel a huge difference. It was so much hotter on the second floor, but it only cost us about $2,000 to finally put in a huge amount of insulation. I think it was R51, 61, He put in a lot of insulation up there and it cost us about $2,000. And immediately the temperature difference, it was night and day. Going up the stairs, there was no difference between how warm or cool it was in the morning and in the afternoon from the main floor versus the top floor. So is this something where instead of putting up solar panels, you can use that same money to make an improvement on your house that will save you electricity and lower your carbon footprint in another way? Have you thought about switching out your electric hot water heater for a heat pump hot water heater? Have you thought about switching out your electric heat for a heat pump? It might be something where spending $6,000 on a new heat pump that works or a more efficient air conditioner is really all you need, and you're gonna get a better payback that way. I don't know. That's up to you, but you should take that into consideration when you're thinking about solar, or if you're thinking about something else, wind power or something on your property. Is there a way that you can just reduce the amount of energy you need in the first place? I wish that I could tell you exactly whether or not solar is ideal for you and what would be the best method moving forward for you, but I don't. I do not know what your situation, but I do hope that this video has given you a few things to think about when you're considering whether or not you should do solar, or if you should put that money into something else that will actually make even more economic and environmental sense for you. I hope you found this video useful and also enjoyable. If you did, please leave a like, subscribe to our channel, and we will catch you in the next one.